Hello everyone, a very happy International Women's Day to all the ladies around the world. Year 2020 was a roller coaster ride for every individual, and it has changed the perception and way of thinking. We have learned and unlearned many things in the year 2020. Amid COVID-19 pandemic also, our judiciary was working and they managed to give some of the significant judgments pertaining to women. Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Priya Sipaha, and in this video we are going to discuss significant judgments pertaining to women in the year 2020. The first one is equal rights of daughter in the co-partner's property. It has been held in the Vinita Sharma versus Rakesh Sharma by the Supreme Court that daughters are equal co-partners in the Hindu undivided family. That means they are having equal rights by birth in the Hindu undivided family. Further, it has been stated that since it is a right by birth like son, there is no need to claim the property. However, the daughter who are born before, they can also claim their rights in the Hindu co-partner's property by the date of amendment, that is 9 September 2005. They can claim their rights by that date. The second one is breaking the glass ceiling in the Indian Army. There is a transformative constitutionalism by breaking gender stereotypes in the Indian Army in the landmark judgment in the Secretary, Ministry of Defense versus Babita Purnia and others. The court said that the women army officers are eligible to be appointed in commanding roles, as well they are also entitled to permanent commissions. Third one is reproductive choice is a fundamental right of a woman. In the case State of Rajasthan versus S, a minor girl was sexually abused and raped, and on the consequence, she got pregnant. She wanted to terminate her pregnancy and it was denied earlier. Then later on, it has been decided that it is purely a choice of a woman and it is a fundamental right of a woman whether she wants to keep her pregnancy or not. It has been held that there is no doubt that a woman's right to make reproductive choices is also a dimension of personal liberty as understood under Article 21 of the Constitution of India. It is important to recognize that the reproductive choices can be exercised to procreate as well as to abstain from procreating. The crucial consideration is that a woman's right to privacy, dignity, and bodily integrity should be respected. This means that there should be no restriction whatsoever on the exercise of reproductive choices, such as women's right to refuse participation in sexual activity, or alternatively, the insistence on the use of contraceptives methods. Fourth one is two-finger test is a violation of women's right to privacy, dignity, and integrity. The Gujarat High Court, in the case State of Gujarat versus Ramesh Chandra Rambhai Panchal, observed that the two-finger test of any rape victim is unconstitutional. The court further held that whether a survivor is habituated to sexual intercourse before the assault has absolutely no bearing on whether she consented when the rape occurred. Section 155 of the Indian Evidence Act does not allow a rape victim's credibility to be compromised on the ground that she is of generally immoral character. The two-finger test is unconstitutional. It violates the right of victim to privacy, physical and mental integrity and dignity. Thus, this test, even if the report is affirmative, cannot ipso facto give rise to a presumption of consent. Fifth one is sexual harassment at workplace is an affront to women's fundamental right. A complaint was filed of sexual harassment at workplace against a senior colleague in the bank. On the consequence, a lady was transferred from that bank. Apex Court in the Punjab and Sindh Bank versus Mrs. Durgesh Kavar observed that the sexual harassment at workplace is a violation of fundamental right of right to equality of any women, and and also the violation of right to live with dignity and practice any profession. Sixth is excluding married daughter from seeking benefits of compassionate appointments is unconstitutional. The Karnataka High Court in Bhubaneswari versus Punnik observed that if son is denying for the compassionate appointment, it is a right of a married daughter also to take a compassionate appointment. The court held that the marriage does not determine the continuity of the relationship of a child with the parent, whether son or a daughter. Son continue to be son both before and after marriage, and a daughter also should continue to be a daughter both before and after marriage. This relationship does not get affected because of marriage. Seventh is, family cannot force a woman to get married. A petition was filed by a 26-year-old girl against her parent that they are compelling her to get married. And it has been decided by the Delhi High Court that any parent cannot force any daughter to get married because she is having a right to live by her own. If she wants to marry, she can marry, and if she doesn't want to marry, she cannot marry. No one can compel her to get married. And the last one is, women can seek residence in the shared household of the husband's relative under the Domestic Violence Act. The Supreme Court observed that a lady who has filed a complaint against a husband and husband's relative under Domestic Violence Act, even if she can live in the shared household of the husband's relative, because she is having a right to live and share the household. No matter that's how the household is husband's own property or the house on a rent or any other house. So that's all about the significant judgments pertaining to women in India in the year 2020. Once again, a very happy International Women's Day to all the lovely lady around the world. I hope you like the video, and if you like it, do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel. You may also follow us on various social media platforms by the name of Law Colloquy. We are having our page on Instagram, on Facebook, Twitter and LinkedIn. We are also having our website, that is lawcolloquy.com, where we used to share legal blogs, legal news, articles, journals, videos and many more things. So that's all for today. See you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.